Now, moving on to the concept of rights. From where did we get the word rights at all? Generally, if you discuss about the concept of rights, it may be fundamental rights or human rights, anything, people just flash the word called Magna Carta of England or the revolutions of England. Then we also have the people discussing about the French Revolution, where the concept of liberty, equality and fraternity have taken their steps or being deeply rooted into the human brains, that people need rights, and these rights are fundamental rights, that is liberty, equality and fraternity. We also have American Bill of Rights, which ensures the same type of rights to all its citizens. So in this way, when we think of the word rights, we'll be flashed with the words of Magna Carta of England, then the French Revolution, American Bill of Rights and all these things. But in the later period after the Second World War, during 1945, the UN was formed. It also works very clearly in order to protect the human rights and to strive for the peaceful settlements of every issue through negotiations and not by violence. So in that, the 9 countries came together, the members of the 9 countries gathered as a group and made a list of 30 articles which formed the later part of the documents of the human rights, and they have formed the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. So the Universal Declaration of Human Rights was framed by 9 countries, and they have made a list of 30 articles which are must, and this was passed by the General Assembly of UNO in the year 1948. So all the member nations, whoever are the signatory members of this UN development or declaration of the human rights, make sure that these are not violated at all. And the UN has clearly working on this aspect and provides that every corner of the world is having the human rights equally accessible to all individuals or the people of the global citizens. But they don't have any legal authority of these rights. If any nation which is not following these rights would obviously attract the international criticism and international economic sanctions, which would make the nation to become tough and difficult for them. For example, let us take Burma or the Myanmar, where the basic human rights are violated, and for 20 years the elected leader was imprisoned, then it attracted international criticism and the people started to put the economic sanctions on that, which forced them to forego and go for the concept of conducting elections. So like that, even though it does not have the legal authority or sanction of it, but it can attract the economic sanctions and bad fame in the international community, which is going to hurt the entire nation for generations. So obviously any nation would not try to stop or interfere in the human rights aspect. And moving on to the development of human rights all over the world, the UN has been striving hard to ensure the human rights to be practiced by every nation and give freedom for the individuals to develop on their own and not to curb the development of their mentalities or economically, socially, politically, any other aspects. So on this initiative, India also being a member of the signatory of UN, it declared in 1993, the government of India has formed the National Human Rights Commission, NHRC. The National Human Rights Commission is being framed and being entrusted with certain powers which it can summarily, it by own itself, can find if it is any violation which is banned for the human rights
It can move to that place, find the investigation facts. If the facts are proven, it can be a civil court authority which can impose or imprison the people and punish them, and can also pass the directives to the governments, to the state government or to the central governments. We also have the human rights in various wings. The commission offices are present. One is the National Human Rights Commission for Women. Then in all the aspects where women are not being treated properly, for the dowries or for any kind of rape, sexual harassments or any kind of other legal problems which are the women are facing, they can move to the UN Rights Commission for Women Council. Then we can go for child rights, the protection of the child rights. If any students or children are not treated properly by the parents, relatives, or if a school management does not behave properly with them, these all people can approach the Human Rights National Commission of Children's Rights Protection Act Council. Then we have the Minority Council, where if any minority groups like Muslims or Christians, Sikh, Parsis, Jains, Zoroastrians, any of these community people who are having any kind of problems or facing any kind of atrocities or any kind of disparity or unequal treatment for them, obviously this would lead, they can complain in the minority council cell. And then we have the state commissions to look after in the various other states. So this has been set up by the Indian government in order to ensure the human rights are being reaching to all people, and all corners of people are having the benefits of having fundamental rights plus the UN human rights. But in moving on to the actual fact, whether these all are being working properly, whether they all are being getting the rights equally in all corners of the world, we have some issues here. Let us see them. The police excessiveness, the police word itself attracts fear for us. We are scared because police may arrest us, police may torture us, policemen may hit us. These are common fears of all the people. So generally people get scared to the word of police. This is another problem. Arbitrary arrests, we don't find, even though the constitution has been clearly specifying you are not being able to be arrested without mentioning the reason, but nobody dares to ask a policeman what is the reason of his arrest. So the arbitrary arrests, and sometimes even government also passes certain kind of arrest warrants which are against the interest of the government, obviously government would try to corrupt them or stop such kind of revolts. So that is called an arbitrary arrest. Then we have the denial of the rights. The rights of many people are being denied, but these people don't know where to approach them and whom to approach. What is the point of view where to go and give a complaint? How to get their rights to be enshrined? All these, the uneducated people, illiterate people don't have much knowledge about this. And corruption, the corruption has been a big, massive disaster which is creating the country to fall down so randomly. Because for everything, we need corruption. We need to pay for everything. We need to give everything for anybody, whomever they need everything. So if you want to work any one small work, legally it has to be done. You have to give the people money under the desks. So this is an illegal money passing on. And one more thing, according to the parliamentary setup of India, we have a detailed discussion procedure of everything. This detailed discussion procedure is causing a continuous delay on the projects, and this is creating lot of misunderstanding for the people, and obviously this would lead to the pass of time very soon. And if it is a judgment, like if a judgment is not given in the right time, obviously it is like the denial of the justice. So justice delayed is justice denied. So this delay is causing harm for many people. And still in some of the villages we have the female infanticide. The female infanticide means killing the small people in the womb itself, finding out by the scan tests that if the girl child is going to be born, they are going to kill her by abolishing that one, doing the abortions, which are again illegal abortions. So like this, there are many things which are being violated at various corners of India, and these people don't know whom to approach, where to approach. In any state, they can approach to the state commission. If it is a larger issue, they can approach to the National Human Rights Commission to get their justice done. But still, we have people who don't have any awareness of what are their fundamental rights, why the fundamental rights are known as basic rights. If you are an educated person, obviously you would have an idea and clarity on your rights and your voting rights or your eligibility criteria. But the uneducated people, where literacy rate of India is still falling under the category of 68% only, and in villages it is less than 40%. Again, in that, for women, we have it very less percentage, and the representation of women in the parliament is also very less. Obviously, these all are making the people to be unaware of their rights, and this is leading for the other people to take it as a chance for them on the weakness of the people, and these people are utilizing that opportunities best and making a choice of that one and making, trying to utilize this misunderstanding or in ignorance or the innocence of the people and spoiling their bright futures. Many girls are being tortured like this. Many girls are being promised that they are going to be provided good jobs, good film opportunities, and they were being sold off to other places. Human trafficking, where it is going on very seriously in our states, which is completely violation of human rights and the fundamental rights. So the governments and the non-government organizations like NGOs have to seriously focus on the violation of the rights, and this has to create awareness to all corners of the world, especially to the village community of people where they don't have access to education at all. These all people have to get access to education. They all have to get an idea on what are their rights, what are their laws, whom they can question them, whom to approach if they have any problem. This all has to be reachable to all corners of the world, and let us hope the UN Human Rights Commission will try to take its steps very clearly through the government of India and pass the information to each and every corner of the nation and ensure if any kind of disparity is found in any corner, they would address it very seriously without any delay and save the society from falling into the crumb of all these kind of atrocities where the innocent people are always mistrust or spoiled or utilized by the arrogant people or the rich landlords or the money lenders, whomever it may be, looking at the opportunity or the need and the necessity of the poor people. The innocence is always being destroyed. Let us hope the Indian Human Rights Commission will work very effectively, and UN also will support for the Indian Human Rights Commission to be implemented very successfully in each and every nook and corner of India. Let's hope the fundamental rights will be the weapons of the common man to question against any kind of violation of it, where the constitution framers have wished the same thing. Let us also wish the same thing, that common man will have rights through his fundamental rights, and this will be like the weapons in his common man's hands, and they can question any actions which are violating the fundamental rights, so that government also would never dare to do any laws which are a breach in the fundamental rights.